So Borderlands 2 has a lot of different guns. You have assault rifles that fire rockets, pistols with infinite ammo, and SMGs that shoot what looks a lot like birds. As you can imagine, there is just a lot of variation among Borderlands 2's weapons. However, some of the weapons in Borderlands 2 are just bizarre. There are some guns that require the player to shoot around an enemy's feet in order to be effective. There are weapons that permanently slag the player while the weapon's equipped. And there are also weapons that can spawn three different barrels, which can cause a lot of confusion for some newer players. Today, I wanted to go over what I think are among some of the most bizarre, strange, and otherwise just weird guns and weapons in Borderlands 2. So I guess without further ado, let's go ahead and start with number 10, and that's going to be the Orc SMG. So the Orc tends to be a somewhat overlooked, but fairly awesome SMG. Like most banded SMGs, it does tend to have relatively low accuracy in exchange for an insane magazine size. However, what's both special and a little weird about the weapon is that it's capable of this short-term boost that greatly increases the weapon's fire rate and reload speed, while also giving it the ability to fire three projectiles that ricochet at the cost of one bullet. The only lame thing about this is that this boost doesn't really last for an extremely long time. However, I think you'll find that it's frequent enough to make it pretty potent up against most mob-type enemies. If you want an Orc SMG, you can acquire one by completing the fifth round of the Magic Slaughter located in the Dragonkeep DLC. And while I wouldn't recommend you farm for one of these in every element, you may find it's a nice alternative to using a Tattler every once in a while. Number 9. The Patriot Sniper Rifle. So, when it comes to sniper rifles, the Patriot is just bizarre. Unlike 99% of the other sniper rifles in Borderlands 2, which are pretty accurate while they're scoped, the Patriot always seems to veer around the reticle of your scope and constantly miss. This is actually made worse by the fact that the Patriot has slow-moving projectiles, and when that is paired with the questionable scoped accuracy, it can be pretty difficult, if not impossible, to hit enemies at a significant distance. Even among other Vladov sniper rifles, the Patriot is a bit of an outlier in the sense that it also lacks a large magazine, where guns like the Liuta or even the Droog may have a magazine size exceeding 20, the Patriot clocks in with a magazine size around 10. It's really the combination of all three of these different attributes that make the Patriot such a strange choice for a sniper user. With that said, you can improve the magazine size and projectile speed somewhat to make the Patriot a little bit better, but still, I wouldn't use this gun for anything beyond medium range. If you want a Patriot, it drops from Master Gi in the Captain Scarlet DLC, but if you ask me, I'd just rather farm Gettle for a Liuta. Number 8. The Error Message Launcher. Depending on how you look at it, the error message is either Master Gi's rocket launcher or, along with the mysterious harpoon launcher from the Big Game Hunt DLC, it's effectively a placeholder weapon that's meant to store the projectile that's used in Master Gi's rocket launcher. I guess for the sake of simplicity, we'll just go with the idea that the error message is in fact Master Gi's rocket launcher. Obviously, the big reason this launcher is so weird is that it can't be acquired through normal means. As the red text reads, this gun should never drop. So in order to actually get your hands on one of these, you will either need a save editor or you'd have to trade with someone that already has an error message. Now, while this launcher isn't overpowered or anything, it is kind of cool that you can shoot these quasi-dart or air-like projectiles that explode on impact. Plus, it's pretty cool that these projectiles deal non-elemental damage rather than either explosive or some form of elemental damage. Otherwise, there's not much else to the error message other than you will need the Captain Scarlet DLC in order to use it. Number 7. The Devastator Pistol. So, the Devastator is a weapon that I feel had a lot of potential. Now, I don't know how many of you guys have played this game, but the Devastator is based off of a dual rocket launcher in Duke Nukem 3D that's of the same name. Duke Nukem's Devastator was insanely powerful and fired rockets at incredibly fast speed to utterly decimate enemies. The Borderlands 2 version sort of leaves something to be desired, however. Not only is the weapon fairly inaccurate, but the projectiles seem to defy the laws of physics by coming from behind the gun rather than out of the gun's barrel. And it's really weird to experience this, as many other weapons in Borderlands 2 don't share that particular phenomenon. What I will say is that if there were fixes for the accuracy, bullet speed, and magazine size on the Devastator pistol, it would actually be a much better weapon. Now, while it would certainly still be overshadowed by the Unkempt Herald, it would at least be more desirable than it currently is. If you want one, though, you can acquire a Devastator from either Master Gi or Hyperius in the Captain Scarlet DLC. With that said, I'd recommend you farm for something else. Number 6, the Cullen SMG. The Cullen SMG is actually one of my favorite weapons in all of Borderlands 2, and this is because it's a dual elemental weapon that deals a combination of shock and slag damage. As you can imagine, this is a pretty cool effect, as you can simply slag enemies by shooting them without having to swap to another weapon. Unfortunately, the Cullen is victim to a somewhat bizarre design decision. Now, the Cullen is the only weapon in Borderlands 2 that slags the player while they wield it, or just have the gun equipped in hand. On the flip side, this actually does make sense because the Cullen is based off of the mythical Irish spearman named Cú Chulainn, and it's said that he was known for Riastrad, which is basically a frenzy where he would both hurt friend and foe alike. Obviously, the self-slag is sort of a reference, and given that the Cullen SMG has the red text that reads Riastrad, it all fits together. If you want a Cullen SMG, you can acquire one at the end of the Hodunk vs. Zaffords Clan War questline by choosing to side with the Zaffords. Number 5, the Logan's Gun Pistol. So, the Logan's Gun is both a pretty great and difficult weapon to use due to its unique attributes. Unlike most guns, which you point directly at an enemy and pull the trigger, the Logan's Gun requires the player to point around an enemy's feet in order to deal damage. In fact, if you try to shoot enemies directly with the Logan's Gun, the bullets seemingly pass through them without dealing much in the form of damage. And while the fact that you have to shoot at and around enemies' feet is pretty bizarre, you can use the Logan's Gun like you would an E-Tech pistol to help regenerate your rocket launcher ammo. So that's a major positive to owning a low-level version. Otherwise, there's not much else to the Logan's Gun. Again, it's pretty weird that you have to shoot around an enemy's foot, but if you want a Logan's Gun, they drop from Wilhelm at the end of the line location that's accessed through Tundra Express. Number 4, the Madhouse Assault Rifle. Out of all of the legendary assault rifles in Borderlands 2, I think the Madhouse had a lot of potential. Now, while the weird projectile pattern doesn't necessarily lend itself to particularly great initial accuracy, what was cool about the Madhouse was its ricochet potential. Provided the Madhouse's bullets hit a surface, like a wall or a ceiling, the bullets will not just ricochet, but also split into additional projectiles. And depending on how you look at this, you could potentially get two shots for the price of one, and I think that's pretty cool. The problem, though, is hitting enemies with the ricocheted bullets. Due to the Madhouse's wobbly projectile pattern, it's actually more difficult to get both the initial and ricochet projectiles to hit your intended targets. Though, if this weapon were ever to return in a future game, that could probably be fixed by giving the projectiles a certain percentage chance to always hit, sort of like Gage's close enough skill. With all of this said, if you want a Madhouse, it drops from an NPC named Mad Dog in Lynchwood. Number 3. The Boom Puppy Assault Rifle. When it comes to bizarre assault rifles, I think that the Boom Puppy may just be the most bizarre one in Borderlands 2. Now, perhaps the best way to describe the Boom Puppy is that it's an assault rifle version of the Rolling Thunder Grenade. So, sort of like how the Rolling Thunder creates an explosion upon each bounce, the Boom Puppy does something relatively similar. As you can imagine, this makes using the Boom Puppy extremely difficult, and given that the Boom Puppy is incapable of performing critical hits like other grenade assault rifles, you really have to wonder if it's worth going to the trouble of taking the time to actually do the side quest required to obtain it. Speaking of that particular side quest, the Walking Dog quest from the Torg DLC is basically a really annoying escort quest. You have to basically escort this flaming skag across the map while enemies are shooting it. However, in order to get the thing to actually follow you, you have to shoot it and then run. It's just pretty frustrating. I guess what I'll say is, while I would recommend that you avoid this weapon, you may find that it's fun to play around with every once in a while. Number 2, the Fibber Pistol. Of all of the weird weapons on this list, the Fibber is the only one that can spawn with one of three different barrels. The first barrel fires multiple slow-moving projectiles and is often considered to be the least desirable of the three barrels. The second barrel, also commonly referred to as the Ricochet Fibber, fires projectiles that can produce even more projectiles, provided that the initial projectile ricochets off of a surface like a wall or a ceiling. Finally, there is the third barrel, which is commonly referred to as the Crit Fibber, which fires a small ball-like projectile in an arc that can deal a massive amount of critical hit damage. Of these three different Fibber variants, the Ricochet Fibber is considered to be the most valuable and is the most sought after because it can fire unlisted projectiles that are compatible with the B. Now, if you are curious, the gameplay that you're seeing in this video is of the Ricochet Fibber. Now, in order to obtain a version of the Fibber, you will need to complete the chain of A Real Boy side quest missions that are available from an NPC named Mal located in the Iridium Blight. Honestly, if you were to farm just one gun on this list, I'd say that it's worth trying to farm for a Fibber because the Ricochet and Crit Fibbers are excellent weapons. And finally, number 1, the Landscaper Shotgun. While the Landscaper in Borderlands 2 is definitely a terrible gun, I do have to say that the Landscaper is actually a pretty cool concept. Think about the idea of a weapon that can lay mines, and when your intended target goes over that mine, it explodes, dealing damage. Basically, this is what the Landscaper is, and is really what it does. The bizarre aspect about the Landscaper, though, is the projectile pattern. In all of my years of playing FPS games, I don't think I have ever seen very many weapons that the player can fire that have the projectiles move away from the crosshairs. Not only does this make laying the Landscaper's mines incredibly difficult, but it also makes it incredibly difficult to use as a conventional shotgun. It's really a shame that the Landscaper was designed this way, because I think if the Landscaper had a much tighter grouping for its projectiles, it dealt more damage, and it received bonuses from grenade damage bonus, it could potentially be a pretty popular gun among the player base. If you want a Landscaper, you have to side with the Hodunks during the final quest for the Hodunk and Zafford Clan War quest line. And if you are curious, this is the same quest where you can receive the Cullen SMG by siding with the Zaffords. It's just that if you want the Landscaper, you have to side with the Hodunks. But alright guys, I think that's going to pretty much wrap up this particular video. If you liked this video, feel free to leave a like and let me know what you think some of the weirdest guns in Borderlands 2 are. Otherwise, like this video if you liked it, click the bell to join the notification squad, and as always, take care and I'll see y'all next time.